So here we are in Reaper. We are going to need to open a new track and then go to Insert Media File because we need the lead vocal there so we can have something to put harmonies to. We're just going to put the chorus of the lead vocal in track one. Then all we need to do is load up Harmony Engine. Notice it is an AU plugin, not a VST. And here's what it looks like. A lot of controls here. Over in the harmony control, you have a number of options. Scale interval is probably the best one for generating correct harmonies for your song. You just need to tell it what key the song is in. Some of the C is in G. So we'll select G, and it's in G major, so we'll leave that alone. And now, if we just hit the space bar to play, you'll hear what it generated.
I'm the wind on the ocean.
Whoa, that was too loud. You probably heard the distortion and see over here where the red marks are. Let's get rid of those. And let's turn these harmonies down. These are the controls for the four harmony voices that got generated. It does that by default, four harmony voices here. So let's turn them down to somewhere near negative 15 and try this again.
I'm the wind on the ocean, I'm one with the land. I'm the mist rolling over the lea.
Okay, that was better. It didn't distort. Let's take a look at these harmony parts. The first one is an octave up from the melody. Next is a fifth up, then a third up, then an octave down from the melody. Notice also that there are controls for each voice, including panning. You can also solo each track to hear each voice individually. Here's the octave up. And here's a fifth up.
I'm the wind on the ocean, I'm one with the land.
And here's a third up.
I'm the wind on the ocean, I'm one with the land.
And here is the octave down.
I'm the wind on the ocean, I'm one with the land.
You're not stuck with those intervals. Each harmony channel has a drop-down allowing you to choose. Let's try changing the first channel from an octave up to a fourth below the melody.
I'm the wind on the ocean, I'm one with the land. I'm the mist rolling over the lea.
So the scale interval harmony control generates harmonies based on the key you give it, and you can change the intervals for each of the four voices to change this around if you want. This can be great if you don't have a harmony part written yet and you want to get ideas. And it can also help if you aren't very good at making up harmonies. But it is not good for recreating existing harmony parts. And what you get in this mode may or may not work with the chord changes in your song. Let's take a look at the next harmony source in the harmony control window here, called Chord Degrees. This will let you tell Evo what chord it should use and when to create the harmony parts. Then you can change the chords in the correct places in the song by pressing these buttons here once you get them set up. Here's how it works. First of all, notice that once this mode, Chord Degrees, is selected, the interval options for each voice go away. This is because whatever chord is being triggered will determine which notes each voice will sing. To use this harmony setting, you'll need to know the chords of your song and when they change. Son of the Sea has four chords in the chorus, G, A minor, C, and D. And you'll also need to know the degree of the chord for the key the song is in, which is much easier than it sounds. I know, I'm sorry, but just a tiny excursion into music theory stuff again. And this stuff is really easy, so you'll be really glad you learned it. It'll help with songwriting and creating harmony parts. Okay, so you have seven chords, A, B, C, D, E, F, and G. And they'll be arranged in some sequence, not always starting with A, depending on the key of the song. For a song in a major key, the first chord, also called the root chord, will be the chord for whatever the key is. For example, with a song in the key of G major, like Son of the Sea, the first chord, also called the root chord, will be G. The song is in G, then the first chord will be G. Then everything follows in sequence. So instead of A, B, C, D, E, F, G, you have G, A, B, C, D, E, F. And the same would be true for whatever major key. So, in G major, if the first chord is G, the second chord is A minor, the third chord would be B minor, the fourth would be C, etc., all the way to F. How do I know the A and B chords are minor? Because those are the rules of music. Here's a handy cheat sheet about the correct chords you can play in a song. I like to use regular numbers, but typically you'll see these in Roman numerals. The one chord would be major, that's the root chord. The two chord would be minor. The three chord would be minor. The four or fourth chord would be major. The fifth chord would be major. The sixth would be minor. And the seventh is actually diminished. Since A was the second chord in the key of G, G, A, 1, 2, it has to be minor, as does the third chord, B, G, A, B, and the sixth, which is E. Anyway, so Son of the Sea is in the key of G. So the root chord, or the one chord, the first chord, is G. Since the next chord is A minor, I just count up from G, starting with 1 on G. So G, A, 1, 2. So A is the 2 chord in the key of G. And as we just saw, that has to be minor because of the rules of music. And since Evo knows the rules of music, it automatically knows that the second chord is going to be minor. So when I choose second, it's going to put A minor in there automatically. Cool, huh? So A minor is the 2 chord. Next is a C chord. So what degree is that? What number is that? Starting with G. Counting, you get G, A, B, C. 1, 2, 3, 4. C is the 4 or 4th chord in the key of G. And we know by our cheat sheet that that's going to be a major. So C major, etc. There. Was that so hard? Okay, now back to Evo. First, I set the key of the song in the key root box up here. So Son of the Sea is in the key of G major. You have to set this correctly in order for Evo to know the chord degrees and output the right chords. So, then I need to assign the chord degrees to these slots over here where it says harmony presets. To start, I want a G chord. So I choose root up here. We know the one chord or the root chord is G in the key of G major. So I'm just going to come down here. And in order to start assigning these chords to these little buttons, click the assign button down here and come up to the chord drop down and make sure root is selected because G is the first chord in the chorus. Then click down here where it says name and type root. Now click this button here under harmony presets to assign it there. Now click assign again and change the chord up here to second. I know this because A minor is the next chord in Son of the Sea and A is the second degree in a G major scale, G A 1 2. So type second down here, then click the next button to assign it there. Click assign again. Now we need a C chord, which is the fourth degree, G A B C 1 2 3 4. So choose fourth from the chord dropdown, type fourth here, click the next button to assign it there, and finally click assign. And we need a D chord, which is the fifth degree, G, A, B, C, D, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And if you look in the dropdown, you'll see that there is no fifth, but there is a dominant. That's because in the rules of music, in a major scale, the fifth chord is not called the fifth chord, it's called the dominant chord. Just go with it. So choose dominant and type dominant in there. Click on the next button, and now we're ready to play through our song. I can change the chords while the song plays by pressing these buttons. So press the space bar to start the song playing.
I'm the wind on the ocean, I'm one with the land. I'm the mist rolling over the lea. I have made human history and I am still here. I'm Manan and the son of the sea.
Now that harmony sounds much closer to the parts that were actually written for the song. And you can solo each voice here to learn